Some time ago, I uploaded a video of my soundbox with an LED strip. Since then, I've received a lot of mails from people asking how they can make it. Therefore, I decided to make this video explaining all the details behind the project. I started by removing the front grille as well as the base reflex port. I also unscrewed the side handle to access the power connection. I decided to go with an addressable LED strip, which allows to individually change colors and brightness for every single segment. For easier connection, I used a 3-pin JST-SM connector, which I soldered to the beginning of the strip. Afterwards, I stuck the strip on the inner rim of the speaker, carefully bending it in the corners and cutting off the excess segments. At this point, we have the LED strip on the soundbox, but there is a problem since the battery supplies 12.8 volts, while the strip requires optimal 5 volts for cork operation. Therefore, we need to find a way of stepping down the voltage. For this reason, we can use widely available DC to DC step-down converters. However, there is one more variable we have to keep in mind. Each segment on the strip contains red, green, and blue emitter, each drawing 20 mA at maximum brightness. This means that in the worst case scenario of white color at full brightness, each LED is drawing 60 milliamps. Multiplying it by 57, which is a number of LEDs I used, we get a maximum of 3.42 amps of current draw. This means that we need to select the buck converter with maximum continuous current rating higher than the calculated value. I found an off-the-shelf module based on XL4015 IC, which can provide 5 amps of continuous output current. The soundbox battery voltage also lays in the range of the converter's input voltage, and the required 5V output can be selected by adjusting the onboard trimmer. Now the strip is powered, but its data line needs to be driven to display any colors. For this purpose, I used an Arduino Pro Mini, HC05 Bluetooth module for wireless communication, and an FTDI programmer to program the Arduino, since it doesn't have the onboard serial programmer. The components were wired together and an additional wire from pin 2 was connected to the soundbox switch, which allows to read the actual switch position and display conditional effects, for example just in the boost mode. Additionally, you can add other modules. For example, in one mail I received, the guys wanted to include an IMU unit to detect the position of the soundbox and display different animations according to the orientation, which I think is pretty cool. So this is the right moment to add all the elements that you want and program the device. The code I used is available on my website and you can find the link down in the description. In case you want the animation to react to music, the easiest way is to get one of these modules that are available on AliExpress. In that case, you can skip the whole Arduino programming part. Alternatively, you can use ESP8266 based modules like NodeMCU or ESP01, which can host a nice web server interface for controlling the strip remotely. And if you use a microphone module and amplifier connected to the onboard ADC, you can program your own sound reactive and remote control solution. Personally, I think that this would be the most versatile and interesting way of doing it, and if I had more time, I would definitely upgrade it to this solution. I hope you got your questions answered, and be sure to share your progress in the comments. Thanks for watching.